Hey guys, Dedex here, and it's been a half a month of using my Google Pixel 6 Pro, which I'd ordered from Ovantika website, and it's a proper time to give you a complete detailed review of this phone, how's this phone working, its condition, and how's Pixel 6 Pro in 2023. And what about experience if you're buying this from Ovantika website? And I've already did a Ovantika review, so you can check from the I button. So let's start with this one. So welcome guys, it's Ofen Dibyansh and you're watching Dedex. So it's a 2021 flagship device from Google, which didn't launch in India, so it's a global device, but everything working real fine here in this one, like no restriction, no block, time to time update, just like in Pixel 6a in India. So let's talk about positive thing first, which is design. Yes, it's a premium looking phone. Even non-techie person takes a look on this phone because its subtle design, its camera module, and obviously its color, which is quite unique, which look really great while holding. So design wise, it's best. And talking about display, a top-notch display, beautifully curved display, but not better than Samsung phone, but still it's look premium. It's a 2K LTPO display, but it's a generation 1 LTPO, so it goes from 10Hz to 120Hz, which isn't that big issue. But there's an adaptive refresh rate which really works super smooth, and that's because of Google prominent software. And yes, Pixel known for its software, Pixel known for a complete stock Android touch, well balanced, no issue, no bloatware, and yes, it reflects when you use this device as your daily driver. So it's running on Android 13 January patch, so it's all latest and you will surely get update time to time. And comparing to previous Pixel, this one has lots of features, animation, productivity and a lot more. So it's a fun to play device. Moving to camera, so Pixel known for its awesome camera, and after many years Pixel changed their complete hardware, so it's a triple camera setup now, and every camera done its job very fairly. The clarity, the color, the light, everything is good in this one. And here is some sample in every lighting condition and the video samples too. But one thing that still needs some fixes, it doesn't have best subject selection and wide angle is not that much wide. So there are few things which need to be looked after. And talking about sound, sound is really good in this one. Better than my previous Note 10 Plus, it's crisp and have little bass and it's loud enough. And multimedia experience while watching content is equally good. No complaint at all, you can set color from setting and it support HDR10, but no Dolby Vision support. Yes, it's good. And it have Gorilla Glass Victus protection on both sides as well. Talking about network and connectivity, yes, it's a 5G ready device with almost major 5G band support, but it need a update to activate it. But if you want to try, you can opt for a beta update program. And talking about 4G services, Jio, Airtel, everything is working fine in this one, no issue at all. You can put one physical SIM, one eSIM in this one, and Wi-Fi 6 is also there, NFC, Bluetooth 5.2, and everything that flagship offer is available in this device. And most of you asked for is payment app working in this one in India, so yes, Google Pay, Phone Pay, everything is working fine, so no such issue in network and connectivity. And it also have wireless charging, river wireless charging, and one feature which I really like, which is also present in iPhone, is that when you double tap on the back of your phone, you can take screenshots and it can be used for multiple features. So yes, there's a lot of gestures control features which can be convenient in day-to-day life. Talking about battery and charging, battery is decent enough to last single day in moderate uses. It's 5003mAh battery, and software optimization is also good that battery really lasts long. Like here's an example, I am playing PUBG for around half an hour and you can see the battery percentage here. And Ovantika didn't provide original charger in the box, so it take time to charge completely from normal fast charger, like it take 2 hours or more than 2 hours to charge from 0 to 100%. Talking about features, yes, a lot of features in this phone. Like in Photos app, you have lots of features in this one. Adaptive charging, this screen lock and unlock transition, animation, always on display. Camera features like cinematic video, action pan, astrophotography, transcribe while recording, live caption, etc. So yes, there's lots of feature and it's a Pixel device, so it's also lack lots of things like dual app protection, etc. which you can find in other Android devices. And first time they added in-display fingerprint scanner in Pixel device, which was uncertain for many reviewers when its launch, as it was not working well sometimes. But throughout the time they fixed it, and I don't find any issue while using in-display fingerprint scanner. Every time it recognized my fingerprint and it's working really fine. But still, it's lack of face unlock yet, which is not quite useful until and unless you have iPhone. So talking about performance, it's great. It's a new chipset by Google, which is Tensor, exclusively for this phone. So it's help in photography, videography, phone, security, performance. So you won't notice anything laggy or buggy in this device. This chipset is doing its work very fairly. And in gaming, I would say it's good, but not great. It's not a gaming phone, but you can do casual gaming easily on this one. But there is one drawback, which I will tell you later. And here's some benchmark score of this device. So now time for some drawback which I faced while using this phone. So first is heating. Yes, this device heat unusually. I don't know why. When you are using this phone under a blanket, it start heating even in normal use. And when you are using your phone for like continuously checking Insta, scrolling web page, lots of app running in your background in continuous manner, or for like if you are waiting for something and you don't have anything to do, so you are using your phone for like 2-3 hours continuously, it start heating strangely from backside. Like this phone telling you it's enough, now sleep or now put your phone back. Maybe possible cause it's a Google, but yes, I've experienced heating issue in this one, which is quite uncertain. And here is throttling test. Not expected this from a flagship phone. It will start throttling very early and there is sudden drop in graph which result in heating. And if you're using this for hardcore gaming, then also you have to deal with heating in this device. Although it cool down very fast in such cases and come to its normal temperature, but yes, there is heating issue in this phone. I have seen Pixel 7 review, so there is also some minimal heating issue, but in this one there is a major heating issue. And sometime in home screen, specifically in home screen, I felt lot of bugs like app crash, sometime it hangs and lag only in home screen. So this is the thing which is quite strange. And it's an imported device, or you can say global device, so no warranty and service by Google India. So you have to be very careful while using this device. And another thing is that you won't easily get its back cover, screen protector, etc. in market. I have searched online, offline market, so no luck, but still I got some ugly looking cover and protection film, which is not looking good, but you can manage it as you have to protect this device at any cost. And next drawback, no call recording. Most of the phone comes with Google Dialer nowadays, but they have call recording option even if it's having Google Dialer. But in this one, they have fully restricted the call recording option, so you can't even use Google own recording feature while in call, which I think it can become very important in certain circumstances. So no luck for recording calls in this one. So guys, that's all. These are the some drawback of this device, and overall it's a great device. It will give you professional touch when you use this phone. It's simple, subtle, and in the same time it's luxury and absolute. So this is the complete detailed review of mine using Google Pixel 6 Pro in 2023. And if there is anything you want to ask, let me know in comment section. And thanks for watching. Do whatever, like, share, subscribe, comment. We will meet in our next video. Till then, take care.